In this lab demonstration, we're going to use customer-supplied encryption keys with cloud storage. Cloud storage automatically encrypts your data on the server side with a Google-managed encryption key before it is written to disk. As an alternative to a Google-managed server-side encryption key, you can choose to provide your own AES 256 key encoded in standard base 64. This key is known as a customer-supplied encryption key. The objectives for our lab demonstration are to create a customer-supplied encryption key, or CSEK, for cloud storage, use our CSEK to encrypt some files in cloud storage, we'll delete a local file and verify that we can still access our encrypted file, then we will rotate the encryption keys without downloading and re-uploading data. For this demonstration, I have created a multi-region cloud storage bucket. I'm now going to download a file from the internet to work with. This can be any file. I'm just using an HTML file from the Apache Hadoop website. I'm also going to make two copies of the file to work with. Now I need to create my own encryption key. Normally you would use some third-party tooling to create, manage, and rotate your encryption keys. But for the purposes of this demonstration, I'll just use the OpenSSL command to create a random string, and then base64 encode it. So here's my new key, and I'm going to copy this to my clipboard so I can use it in a moment. Cloud storage uses a configuration file called .boto to store encryption keys, amongst other things. This file may not exist in your environment, but we can auto-generate this file with the gsutil config -n command. Inside the file, I'll search for the encryption key parameter, and I'll uncomment this and add my new encryption key. Now I'll upload some files to my cloud storage bucket, and they'll be encrypted using my new customer-supplied encryption key. I can see the two files I've just uploaded to cloud storage in the cloud storage UI, and I can see that they are encrypted with a customer-supplied key. Let's try deleting our local file and downloading it again from our cloud storage bucket. And we can see that our key is also used to access our encrypted files from cloud storage. Note that we're just storing the key in the .boto configuration file for demonstration purposes. Cloud storage itself does not permanently store your private key on Google servers or otherwise manage your key. Instead, you must provide your key for each cloud storage operation, and your key will be purged from Google servers after the operation is complete. Cloud storage will only store a cryptographic hash of the key so that future requests can be validated against the hash. Your key cannot be recovered from this hash, and the hash cannot be used to decrypt your data. Let's simulate the process of rotating keys. To do this, I'll first generate a new key. And in my .boto file, I will hash out my original encryption key and add my new one. I'll then use my original encryption key as a decryption key. Now I'll upload a third file to my bucket, which will be encrypted with my new key. At this point, setup.html and setup2.html are encrypted with the original key, and setup3.html is encrypted with the new key. Let's demonstrate how I can use both of these keys by deleting setup2.html and setup3.html from my local file system, and then re-downloading them from the bucket. I can access both files because even though one was created with my new key, I still have access to my old key for decryption. Rotating keys on a file can be done without having to download and re-upload that file. I can use the gsutil rewrite command to rewrite the encrypted file. This will cause it to be decrypted with the old key and re-encrypted with the new key. So at this point, setup.html has been rewritten with my new encryption key, and setup3.html was already encrypted with my new key. The setup2.html file is still encrypted with my original key. So let's see what happens if we don't rotate our keys properly. We'll simulate this by removing our old key from the decryption key value in our .boto file. Let's remove all the local copies of our files and try to download them again from our bucket. We can access setup.html because we rotated its key to our new key. And of course, we can access setup3.html because it's only ever been encrypted with our new key. But we can no longer access setup2.html. It's still encrypted with our old key, which we no longer have access to. That concludes this demonstration.